because you are a songwriter. And you, like, that is your first trade, right? Mm-hmm. Like, you, because you perform, but you also write a lot of songs that other people perform.
So wait, correct? Instagram characters are not your first trade?
I mean, they could
or
be.
Are they?
Or are they?
Or am I shifting into a new season of life?
Oh, I love Susie my mind so much. Susie, is that her name? Yeah, anyway, Susie, love her. Susie. Okay, so my question is this. How, put us in, like, the mind of a songwriter for a moment, because when you, what you're doing, we just talked about how the song When Love Was Born, it really highlights the humanity and the physicality and the reality of the situation of Jesus' birth. Mm. And Mary and Joseph, this song that you're about to sing, does too.
The same, yeah.
Yeah, and so, like, there's a imagination. Like, what I want to talk about, and we probably don't have time to talk about, is, like, the concept of the Christian imagination. Mm. And how you, as a person who, you believe God's word is true, mm. yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and so, like, and but you are also using your imagination to kind of fill in some blanks of the story. And so, like, that feels a little tenuous. Like, how do you carry that? Like, what,
that's a
how
really
does that happen?
It's such an appropriate question for this song. Oh, my gosh, you're so good.
We didn't even plan that.
No, you know, so this song, Mary and Joseph, was funny because I wanted to write something that was sort of in this vibe that was like a little guitar thing I could do by myself and had like a little music theme. And, you know,
you wrote it for this podcast?
Well, years ago. I'm a soothsayer.
Wow.
I'm a seer. you say that that's very well enunciated. I think one thing I'm so fascinated with just globally with scripture is the reality of it. Yeah. Is this idea, like I spoke to contextually, but really realizing that this stuff, if you believe it, you believe that it happened. This isn't, you know, like pontificating on a theme. No. And so I think for me, scripture is the most profound when I put it in the context of its reality. So when I was writing the song, I thought, I wonder what it would have been like if Jesus had been born 2,000 years later. Hmm. Like, what would that have looked like? Like, you know, and so it's kind of fun to sort of think a little bit about, like, you know, just what that would have felt like, sort of, and mainly, again, to your point, just to kind of shock you awake. Like, wait, why did you say that word? Oh, that's interesting. Like, oh, yeah, that's...
I told Amanda yesterday that it was like this song specifically. It's like putting fingernails on the people and putting dirt under their fingernails. And she said, don't say that. That's disgusting.
And yet, here we are.
And thanks for taking my advice, Raechel.
Yeah.
But it makes them real. Like, I think that, like, there's...
They are.
You know what? Fingerprints.
Yeah.
They have fingerprints.
Yeah.
They're real.
That's my hope. I think, you know, again, I think one of the hardest things about anything that's faith related and trying to sort of write about it is, you know, it's just been around for so long. And so it's hard to know how do you talk about something that hadn't been said before, which is just songs in general.
And but like I think, you said about familiarity.
Oh yeah. And so I think some of the fun that you can have, I mean, that's the thing that was so profound to me about hearing Mary, Did You Know the first time, which is a big inspiration for When Love Was Born, is take the other perspective. But there's some lines in that song that you're just like, I've never thought about that.
Mm-hmm,
like, it's just profound, but it's still true. Mm-hmm. And it's a little variation on a theme that's okay to take some liberty with because it doesn't do anything that's, you know, like against the grain.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just fun to kind of get out of your head for a second and go like, oh yeah, that would be, how did Mary feel about that?
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know,
sometimes we get appropriately so wrapped up in the divinity of Jesus that we sometimes need to take a minute and remember the humanity.
Yeah. For sure. But yeah, I mean, so that's kind of where this song came from, was just this idea of like, wouldn't it be fun to sort of think about what's an easy access point to people who may have heard this thing and all of a sudden they're like, oh, that you're using a couple words here and there that feel like make me want to listen a little more. So
like, how do you know she was the
exactly.
Or whatever.
Exactly.
And it's like, wait. But the point is,
Maybe it's in as much just for me to shock me out of, you know, to our point about Advent, to sort of repurpose and think differently and a little more purposefully about something that I've already thought about a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe I think I have, you know, maybe not as much as I want. But so this is that song. This is a song called Mary and Joseph, which, fun fact, Tim McGraw has recorded.
Tim,
for those who may hear mine and go, and I'll tell you a really quick funny story sidebar. Years ago, probably a decade ago, when I wrote this song, I had a friend that worked with him and was like, hey, Tim is looking for Christmas songs. And I just recorded my first album, which was called Very Merry Christmas. And so I sent him all the originals I wrote, all five, like sent them to her. She was like, no. And I was like, okay, here's the next one. Like, no. And I was like, okay, here's the third one.
Hurt feelings,
no.
But okay.
And I didn't send this song because I was like, it's too weird. Like, this is like that weird, weird, weird song. Like, it's me and a guitar. It's sort of like an old folk song kind of vibe. And so she's like, listen, these aren't the right fit. Is there anything else you have? And I was like, oh, I got this other one. And literally emailed it 5 minutes. So she's like, cool, he's going to record it tomorrow. I was like,
wow.
Boy, music is a funny thing, isn't it? I was like, right. There's just no way. But
when
it's
you think,
really,
just when you think you know Tim.
Yeah, well, sweet Tim. Timmy Mac Magoo. I don't call him any of those things, at least to his face. But yeah, so this is a song called Mary and Joseph. Mary was the first of three, long black hair and sugar sweet, daddy's eyes and mama's crooked smile. Yeah. She was barely 17, kept a job keeping dishes clean, planned to stay in the city for a while, yeah. For a while. Joseph ran a lumber yard about a mile from Olive Park. Quiet boy, he never had much to say. It was love right from the start. He bought a ring and won Mary's heart. Had hopes for a home and kids someday. Kids someday. Scared her half to death. She would have screamed, but she lost her breath on a midnight there in the middle of me. He said, oh Mary, don't be afraid. You'll bear a son that the Lord has made. Name him Jesus, he'll save the day. To go to Bethlehem, but there was nowhere left to stay. So in a barn she gave birth, the King of Kings, the Lord of Earth, just a little bitty thing sleeping on the hay, sleeping on. Story's too long to tell, but he walked on water and lived through hell. Died on a cross, rose from the grave. We got a king, they got a son. Mary and Joseph were the only ones there on that very first Christmas day. There on that very first Christmas day.